Carving pumpkins is a fantastic Halloween tradition where usually we'll carve a face into our pumpkin. We want to do something like that today, but not the normal jack-o'-lantern face that you may be used to. I'm going to see if I can carve mine and Grant's faces into this pumpkin. Guys, I wanted to jump in with a quick update that our upcoming mystery project has been guessed, and we will be contacting the winner in the coming week. Everything isn't quite ready to launch just yet though, so here is a sneak peek at what's to come. Any ideas what it could be? Head on over to Instagram to vote in a poll and use the hashtag TKORCreator to share your guesses. Don't forget to click the link in the description to sign up for our mailing list so you're the first one to find out what's inside. Now, I should be upfront and say this is not, in fact, a real pumpkin. This is an artificial pumpkin, mostly made of expanding foam. It's designed to carve and cut like a normal pumpkin, while not having to worry about whether it's going to rot. After you've carved these, you can store them and use them for as long as you want. The pumpkin I'm using here is made by Funkins. I got this one at Joann Fabrics, but I believe they're sold in several stores. The idea is simple. I'll take some pictures of myself and Grant, throw them on Photoshop, and play with the levels until they're a good match for what we're going for on the pumpkin, and then try to transfer that image onto the surface of our gourd. The first step is going to be making the photos and editing them on Photoshop to make them look right for this pumpkin surface. So let's grab my computer and see what we can do. Now, for people who do understand the basics of Photoshop, what I am doing, for the most part, is just increasing the contrast a fair amount and then adding a color gradient map over the Photoshopped layer so that the darkest color is approximately the color of a pumpkin in very low light, so a very dark orange or almost a brownish color. And the light is the color of a pumpkin that's carved really thin with a light inside of it. You can see on my gradient that it's going from this really darkish color up through orange, through yellow, and to this very whitish yellow. And that's about the color gradient that you get when you're actually carving a pumpkin. Now, to simplify the design just a little bit, I'm gonna run it through this filter gallery that just sort of gives me some edge guidelines. And I'm not even necessarily going to follow these perfectly, but they'll make it easier to measure and compare to later on. Now we need to print these out the same size that we want them to be on the pumpkin, and it may take some trial and error of growing it and shrinking it just a little bit to see what's really gonna fit best, but we do want to print it at the actual size that we're gonna have it show up on the pumpkin. I'm now just using scissors to cut off a lot of the extra paper, and this is gonna help us get the paper to lie as flat as it can. Pumpkins are not flat, and the carving will not be flat, but we do want to get the paper about as flat as we can onto the pumpkin. So we're just gonna remove a lot of the excess, and then we'll just sort of have to make it up a little as we go with the rest. Just throw a pin in here, hold that. Now these are pinned in place, and we're also going to use the pins to do some marking. We can't really trace through the paper onto the pumpkin, so what we're gonna do is use the pin to poke through the pictures into the pumpkin to leave some marks in important places. Then after we've got those marked in, we'll go in with a Sharpie and maybe fill in some of the lines a little bit more completely. So you can see on the skin of the pumpkin that I can leave very small marks and they'll still show up pretty well in the skin of the pumpkin. So I can use that to sort of draw lines through the paper onto the skin. I've now gone through on my face. I haven't yet done Grant's, but I've gone through on my face and I've poked holes lining a lot of the important spots. Especially what I've done is mark out all of the darkest parts. I've sort of made an outline around that. And the reason is those parts aren't going to get removed at all. We're going to leave that as the skin because the skin blocks the most light and we do want to have a light inside the pumpkin. So when that shines out, the parts with the skin will be very dark. I've also gone through and marked some other important lines, but those may not show up very well because the first step is going to be to remove the skin from all of the parts that aren't going to be dark. And once I do that, I may not be able to see any of those holes that I poked anymore. Now I've pulled the print off and all of the holes are still there, but you can't see a whole lot of detail. So it's really good to take this fine point marker and just go over some of those spots and trace them out. We've now got all of the lines drawn out for both Grant's and my face, and it's time to start doing some carving. And the first step is we're gonna use an X-Acto knife to just cut along most of those lines and start peeling and cutting away the skin of the pumpkin, leaving behind the orange foam behind it. And all of the spots that are gonna remain dark, we're gonna leave the skin on. But as soon as we do that, we're gonna go into the next step, which is shading. And what we do is anywhere that needs to be lighter or more yellow in our prints or on the computer screen, we need to cut farther into the foam so it gets even thinner, lets more light through, and makes for a lighter color. And the way we're actually gonna do that is turn the lights down all around, and we're gonna cut a hole in the top like you do with a standard pumpkin and put a light inside so we can see when we're achieving just the right amount of carving. That way we'll have a real-time feedback system to know if we've carved deep enough or needed to carve deeper. You can see inside, one of the nicest things about one of these pumpkins is you don't have to spend a lot of time scraping it and carving it out of the inside. It's already carved out, nice and hollow, just like we want it. Let's turn off all of the lights and see what that's looking like. So now you can see with the light inside the pumpkin, just a little bit shines through the skin, and it's not perfectly even because the foam on the inside is not 100% the same thickness. And that's very, very similar to what you would run into with an actual pumpkin. Pumpkins aren't perfectly universally thick, they aren't perfectly universally dense, and so you really get a lot of this same look with a real fruit or with the artificial one. So right away you can see the light difference between where there is and is not the skin. And so this is going to be sort of our base color for everything that is not completely dark. So we'll have the skin on in some places, and then this will be the darkest point, and we can get lighter from there just by carving farther and farther into the walls. Well, the pumpkin is finished and I am completely covered in pumpkin dust, which is not a thing that happens if you use a real pumpkin, but it is a thing that happens if you use these artificial pumpkins. The pumpkin carving is complete, and now that I have vacuumed myself off and I'm no longer covered in the dust from this, we can talk about what we've done. I am very happy with how this turned out. Even though I've done stuff like this before, it's always a little nerve-wracking, like, oh, is it gonna work this time? This, as it is, took me 5 or 6 hours to do, but it is not a very quick process overall. So it might be something you wanna give yourself a day or two to work on. I do wanna talk about the difference between artificial pumpkins and real pumpkins when you're carving. They both have some advantages and disadvantages. Where I live, at least, real pumpkins are way cheaper. This thing was on sale 40% off and still cost 30 bucks. A pumpkin, even one this size where I live, would only be maybe 12. And if you wanted to practice, then smaller pumpkins are really cheap, like 2-3 bucks for a decent sized pumpkin. That's not true everywhere. Some places pumpkins are more expensive, but I would say for practicing, a real pumpkin's much better. This, of course, will last indefinitely unless someone breaks it, which is possible. There are lots of kids who live in this house. Carving real pumpkins and artificial pumpkins is different. Just about any tool that you can scrape with will do an okay job for carving a real pumpkin. This foam has a very different texture. If you try and just scrape at it, it roughs it up, but it doesn't really carve anything away. So you probably saw that by far the most useful tool for me was a rotary tool. This thing just spins, and with a slightly rough or drill-like tip on it, it does a really good job of just cutting through the foam, and all you need is a steady hand to just take off exactly what you want. You can go over it slowly, taking away little bits at a time. A real pumpkin is usually a little bit more yellow than this. These pumpkins have this foam, which is slightly yellow, but a little bit white, at least for now. It's possible that if you left it out in the sun for a while, it would turn more yellow. So you're gonna get a slightly different effect when you put a candle or a light inside it. We've been using an artificial light because there's no airflow and we don't want to burn our pumpkin down. With a real pumpkin with holes that you've carved into it, normally a real candle will do a great job. Not a good plan for urethane pumpkins. I also really love how nonsensical it looks when you're looking at it with external light and no internal light. It barely looks like it's people at all, and you definitely can't really tell what's going on. And it's fun to watch how much that changes when you take down the external lights and light it up from the inside. Guys, I love jack-o'-lanterns. I love seeing all the artwork. So whether you use this tutorial, this style, or not, I wanna see what you've carved. Post your jack-o'-lantern on Instagram and tag us at thekingofrandom. I wanna see what you've got. Guys, that's all for today, but the fun's not over. That box at the top will take you directly to our last video, and you should check that out. The other box will show you what YouTube thinks you should be watching next. And if you're not a subscriber yet, just hit this bomb to get in the club, and that way you'll never miss out on the fun. Don't forget to ring that bell, and we will see you in the next one. Talk to you then.